Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the blood reservoir function of the veins. Let's get started. Veins have thin walls, and their lumen is ellipsoidal at low volume of blood. So the veins have high compliance. Or in simple words, they show so much distension, even with a small increase in pressure. This makes them a good place to store blood. And therefore, the veins are actually the blood reservoirs for circulation. Usually they hold more than 60% of all the blood in the circulatory system. Of course, this much blood is not required to be present in the veins. When needed, for example, after hemorrhage, the brain sends signals to veins to constrict. So the blood shifts from the vein to the remaining circulation and compensates for the lost blood. So the functions of blood circulation do not suffer much. So this is how the blood reservoir in veins is useful. Now please note that this single large collection of blood that I have shown here is just a metaphor. In reality, the venous reservoir is dispersed throughout the veins of the body. Some of the important sites among these are the spleen, liver, venous plexus beneath skin, and large abdominal veins. These sites store extra blood in their veins, ranging from 100 to several hundred milliliters. So these are some important specific blood reservoirs. Apart from veins, the heart and lungs can also lend some blood to the rest of the circulation if needed. For example, during sympathetic stimulation, the heart shrinks and operates at about 50 to 100 milliliters lower volumes than usual. So the blood shifted out of the heart can be used in circulatory function. Similarly, the lungs can also contribute 100 to 200 milliliters of blood when pulmonary pressure decreases. So this was all about blood reservoir functions of the veins. Now let's have a quick summary. Due to high compliance, the veins are the blood reservoir of the body. Some important locations where blood is stored are the spleen, liver, large abdominal veins, and venous plexus beneath the skin. And even the heart and lungs can also provide some contribution as needed. Now, today's bonus point is only for those who are really thinking that the reservoir is some fixed portion of blood stored like a bottle. See, all the blood is flowing all the time, including the one that we consider a reservoir. By reservoir, what we basically mean is that that much volume of blood is not needed at that location at any point in time. So the extra blood can be shifted to remaining circulation as needed, without any compromise in functions. In short, it's a dynamic reservoir in a flowing river, rather than a static pond. Yeah, I know this assumption is too silly to have, but by any chance, if you had it, you got the clarity now. That's it for this video. Please press all the YouTube buttons that you find beneath this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.